So if we were to just stop right there, right? If we were to just stop after the setup procedure, we'd essentially have a world that looks like this, right? It's just a straight line of the agents right across the middle of, well, not the middle, but the 100th x value of the world, right? But what we want them to do is we want to have them actually take some actions. And so let's talk a little bit about what the go code is, which is the button we would push next to actually start the model up and running. So if you look at the go code, it basically only does three things, really. The first one says, if you have any wealth, then transact. And if you remember correctly from the beginning, right, we said that in this model, as long as you have a dollar to your name, you're going to go out and spend it, right? And you're going to go out and spend it by giving it to one other random agent in the world, right? And we'll talk a little bit about that in the next video where we talk about the transact procedure, right? But essentially, that's all you're going to do. You're going to ask the turtles with wealth greater than zero, which takes the set of all turtles, finds the ones who have wealth greater than zero, and then ask them to do this transact action, right? However, there's one other small issue we can run into, right? It is possible, as we continue to run our model again and again and again, and I'll speed it up a little bit, right, that we could get some agents that are going to be way down on the right-hand side of the world. And what we don't want to do is have them actually move off the world, right? So we're limited on the left side by zero because our agents can't have less than $0. We've just built that in. They can't spend a dollar they don't have, right? There's no debt in this particular model, right? But they could, however, earn wealth that's greater than $500, right? You could have a $1,000 agents, right? And our world only goes up to $500 worth. And so I'll continue to run the model, and as you can see, they're moving to the right. I don't want, in the interest of time, I'm not gonna run it until they actually hit that level. But one little thing you might notice, and we can actually turn off the view updates to kind of speed up a little bit if we want. But one thing you might notice is that they could, obviously, they're heading in that direction, they could hit that edge of the world. So we add a little bit of code just for display purposes that says, ask turtles, and this applies to all turtles, whether or not their wealth is greater than zero or not, which doesn't really matter too much because it's only going to apply to the ones with their really high wealth. If their wealth is less than or equal to the max PX score, set their X score to wealth. In other words, all turtles, no matter where you are, as long as you don't have more than 500 in wealth, right, then set your X score equal to your wealth. So if you have $1, set it to 1. If you have $5, set it to 5, right? But really the goal here is that we're just updating the visualization and we're essentially making sure that they don't move too far away. If we took this if wealth less than or equal to max X score, just said set X score wealth, we get an error eventually because we might have an agent who gets $501 and tries to move off the world, right? So this is just controlling that fact, okay? And then the final thing we do is say tick. And all tick does is tell all the graphs and tell the little counter that you see here at the top of the NetLogo interface that it's time to go on to the next step. We've got a couple agents now. They're running long enough. They're getting close to that 500, right? So those are just, that's all the tick does. And that's the go procedure in a nutshell, right? It's a very, very simple go procedure, and yet it creates some interesting behavior that we'll see.